So Katrina was like the first thing, the first like tragedy that happened on a national level that I felt like I was old enough to really understand kind of what was happening and understand the points that people were making on the news about how like FEMA wasn't really taking care of people and stuff like that. And then to hear like my favorite rapper talk about like these same topics, but from his perspective, which I feel like is our perspective, you know what I mean? For him to come at it from that way and just really speak his piece on it, it was like, it gave you insight to more like a human approach and a human experience of like this sensational thing that was on the news every day and all these videos, like, you know what I'm saying? It would just seem like, it seemed theatrical until I heard this song, and it kind of like put it in perspective.
Yeah. Suffix people. You know.
I was probably in like sixth grade or something like that, sixth, seventh grade. And my brother burned it, and he burned me a copy of it, and we used to ride around in his whip listening to it. But I just remember every day for like what seems like years looking back on it, you know what I'm saying? Listening to that mixtape like all the time on the way to school, all the time on my bike, all the time on train, you know what I mean?
Kicking rocks on the block, telling all the OGs, I be coming for your spot when you're not looking.
Hot cooking, mama got it on the kitchen table. I thank God we were always able to get the leather couch, big screen cable too. Nintendo when the good grades came through, but then the cook case came through. Some soft, some stepped on, but we kept on. You know what I mean? It's like you start from that adolescent place of like, I had so much opportunity. Like I'm from a place where nobody has anything, but I'm grateful that, you know, my mom worked hard and we was always able to, even though we lived in a shitty apartment or in the hood, you know, there's a lot of families where your mom is working two jobs, working all day. You know, you getting watched by your family members, you on daycare, you getting watched by your older siblings and all that, and you don't really feel it. Like, I could relate to that, because when I was young, we didn't have a lot, but I never felt it till I got older, and I realized the corners my mom had to cut and stuff, you know what I mean? Because she was really making it happen. And then to take that same place of innocence and translate that into, like, you know, but then that work came through, then we start learning how to make it on our own, and it seemed like the only option. So, yeah, to hear him take it there, that smoothly and that quickly, it was so relatable because that's how real it happens in real life. Like one day you really playing football with your friends and then the next day you could meet somebody from your neighborhood and start like, you know, a criminal enterprise, so to speak. You feel me? And it's that blink of an eye.
I'm just doing a buck down memory lane. If I crash, just pick up my brain. And yes, my niggas the same, but they quicker to bang. And if they do, then I'm the nigga you blame. So I shoot first anyway. And I would do the honors any day and tell your honor he a bitch to his face.
He starts with how he grew up, you know what I mean? Starts with talking about his mother, then goes into what happened when he first got introduced to whatever that lifestyle may be or the people who were doing that, you know what I mean? And then goes into how, you know, how the tragedy of Katrina affected everybody from the whatever you would perceive as the top to the whatever you would perceive as the bottom, and kind of equalized everything, you feel me? You know, this wouldn't surprise me coming from 40-year-old Jay-Z. You know what I'm saying? Like somebody who really had the time to sit and think and, you know, mature their perspective. This is coming from somebody in essentially the height or what is soon to be the height of their prime, you know what I mean? He could have easily swept that under the rug and just made a turned up song. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's like a sense of responsibility down there.
The people who ain't never had shit ain't gonna never have shit. Bullshit, cause they still gonna try and manage niggas doing anything like God gonna understand them. But please understand us, niggas with money lost mansions, niggas with nothing lost families. Lives lost in traffic, water up to the attic, there goes the stashes. But a nigga got passion, even though the bounce back seeming like magic.
Regardless of what level you thought you had achieved, once this thing happened that was insurmountable, we're all fucked up. You could have had $1 million in your attic. You got water up to the attic. That stash literally is gone. You know what I'm saying? You thought you were the man, you thought you were on. And that just speaks to the lack of real power we have when we don't have like the stability and the structure, you know what I'm saying, to really have like, you know, prosperity on a financial level at least.
Stand up if you know it's true, the end of the world coming in my city to prove, damn. And this is after disaster, this ain't rap, this a recap.
Yeah, like, come on, man. My mans was touching on, like, global warming and all type of shit. The end of the world coming in my city, the proof. And this is after disaster. This ain't rap. This a recap. You know what I'm saying? This is, like, this not even a rap song. This is literally just me telling you what happens. You know what I'm saying?